Warning, The Michael Savage Show contains adult language, adult content, psychological nudity. Listener discretion is advised.
And now, America's most exciting radio talk show, The Savage Nation. Here is Michael Savage.
This song goes out to the men over 70 in Mexico City. We learned today that Mexico City's governor or mayor is going to give out Viagra to men 70 years and over because sexuality has a lot to do with quality of life and our happiness. Men in Mexico City, Vaya con Dios. This song goes out to you.
Baby, don't you let your door bite me.
The Savage Nation Rock and Roll Friday. I'm Michael here driving the FA-18 Hornet of radio. Trying to do a few turns without crashing or careening. And you're welcome to call the program at any time if you can get through. Good luck to you because I doubt it. Because I'm in a good mood. It's Friday. You're in a good mood. The election's over. We don't have to pay any attention anymore to the clowns. Let them do what they all do, which is rob us blind. Oh, yeah, you thought when Obama became president, your life was going to get better. He was going to give you a new Camaro. You were going to all have a new Camaro in your driveway. It's unbelievable. Everything he promised, they backtracked already. Harry Reid said today, we're not really going to bail out GM. We can't afford it. Then he said, we may not be able to grant amnesty to the illegals. We can't afford that. I told you that at the end of the day, these are front men for the real powers that be, who I don't know who they are. There's probably some guy in an undershirt in New York on 2nd Avenue runs the world. I never met him. But it looks to me like there's one guy somewhere on 2nd Avenue over a tailor shop in an undershirt who sits on a pillow and looks out at the street, and he knows what's going on. He makes a call, and boom, they do what he wants. I have this fantasy about the whole world. God forbid it should be true. No, we live in an open democracy. We live in a participatory democracy where if you have a grievance, you go to your congressman or your senator, and they do exactly what you want. They represent you. Oh, yeah. As long as you have a bag of cash in the Holiday Inn on Highway 15 behind Harry's House of Rubber, you can get anything you want from Congress. Is it any wonder the show is banned in Boston, so to speak? How can you take such alacrity? How can you take it? The answer is you need it, because without it, you'll go crazy altogether. So here we are, and you can call about anything that you want. I mean, there's so many news stories. Who can keep up with them? You go crazy from them. No wonder my family doesn't want to talk to me about politics. They say, stop giving bad news. I said, there's no such thing as good news. There hasn't been good news in ages. In fact, the news business is built on bad news. Otherwise, you wouldn't pay attention. The object is to get you so crazy that you listen for more bad news. You're like a condition. You're conditioned to hear what's bad. What happened? What'd you say? Really? I didn't... Bad? It's terror. Are you kidding? Acid attack. Saudis, madrasas, Wall Street gangsters. I told you, saying, sure, gangs are bad if you're there knocking people off. There's no one's going to say that's good to kill a person. A life is a precious thing. But when you see the gang on Wall Street, what they're getting away with, okay, say like a guy pulls off a heist, the alarm goes off, he robs a jewelry store. They break into a bank or they hold up a house. Terrible. But what do you do when a gang breaks into Wall Street and robs the Treasury and does so every day, day in and day out for 3 months now? And then when they absorb the money that you gave them, they print more or they take more. It's the biggest theft in the history of the world, and this guy's getting away with it. It's the number one theft in the history of the world. It's more money than you ever could imagine could be robbed, and nothing's happening. They rob more. Henry Paulson, in my opinion, the bailout plan, which is not working, they're saying it's not working. And the media is going along over and over again. Henry Paulson, Hank Paulson, Henry Paulson, the right man for the right job, Henry Paulson. I told you, I was the first one to tell you he came from Goldman Sachs. Now, unto itself, Goldman Sachs doesn't mean anything. It's an investment bank. They were doing well. They did well. But when they were doing bad, you got to look into who they are. How did they get there? How did Henry Paulson become the Treasury Secretary? Who told Doofus Bush to appoint Hank Paulson? You have to look into that, too. Guess what? If you find out who actually told the genius George Bush to appoint Henry Paulson to the Treasury Department, it was an advisor named Josh Bolton, right? So, all right, Josh Bolton, terrific. Chief of Staff, Josh Bolton. But it turns out from 1994 to 1999, he was Executive Director for Legal and Government Affairs at Goldman Sachs International in London. So when I said to you this is a government of Goldman Sachs, by Goldman Sachs, and for Goldman Sachs, no wonder they want to ban me in Boston, so to speak. They can't take such alacrity. They can only take guys who wrap themselves in the flag and tell you, oh, Republicans good, Democrats bad, Obama's a socialist, the Republicans are not. So what do you call about government socialism? Well, that's a different kind of socialism. That although Obama wants socialism, even though Paulson's practicing outright socialism by buying companies and letting the government run them, that's not real socialism because it's a Republican kind of socialism, which is a different kind of socialism. So that's why I say to you, can you play the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the Goldman Sachs that I played before the election. But you didn't understand that. You didn't understand what I was doing. So I'm watching like the B-Babes on Weather Channel now. I'm feeling much better because I don't watch. I tuned off all of the cable channels. If you think I want to watch Wolf Blitzer in a bad suit, or you think I want to watch, I'm Britt Hume. How are you? I'm Britt Hume. How are you? I'm Britt Hume. What do you do for a living? I'm Britt Hume. How are you? I'm Britt Hume. How are you? I'm Britt Hume. What's a Britt Hume? I don't know, but I'm Britt Hume. Presidents like me. I'm at dinners. I'm a Britt Hume. Although my eyes look like I'm a turtle, I'm Britt Hume. I sleep in my suit at night. I'm Britt Hume. How are you? What are you talking about today? Whatever they're giving you, whatever the guy with the big glasses in the back writes, I'm Britt Hume. How are you? I don't want to watch these guys anymore. So I'm turning on the Weather Channel because it's refreshing to see girls who wear clothing that, A, is so out of style they wouldn't wear it in Tonga, and, B, two sizes too small so that their bodily, so their hourglass figures, which they don't have, show. Let's put it to you that way. They're ordinary women, and they have, some of them have funny faces. They're never going any further than this. A lot of people think that the Weather Channel is a step to something. It's not a step to anything. This is it, $39,000 a year until you lose your looks altogether. Then you go to work for the ASPCA in the euthanasia department while the animal's being put out. You stroke its head like the midget in my book in the laboratory who helped euthanize the mice. The midget who worked for that doctor who fired me and said, go, you're making $300 a month, and if you don't kill the animals, you're making nothing. I said, well, I'll make nothing, and they threw me out of the laboratory. I had to go look for a new job. But it's that leads me to another story, which is that whenever you think it's darkest, it usually is. But sometimes, and it's very rare, it's darkest before the dawn, but generally it's over. Whenever you think it's darkest, as usually is, everything's over. But I have found that in many cases, or in some cases, even though it's very dark, if you got the guts to hang in there, eventually something better will happen. But here's the trick. It's usually many years later. It's not like the next day. In the Walt Disney version, it's like you get fired and you say, oh my God, that's terrible. And you think that because you listen to Republicans in the radio that, well, use the free market and you're going to go out. The next day, you're going to have a chain of businesses. It's like 25 years later and a heart bypass later. Then maybe things turn around for you. I'll be right back.
This is me and I'm in love again. Had no love and say you know when. You know I love you. Yes, I do. And I'm saving all my love in jail for you.